fastest growing cities in every U.S. state. Unexplored world and a skewed world. I want to open up GeoDetective and see. This map is intended for non-moving games. Difficulty is mixed, so some locations are meant to be hard. Due to Street View updates, sometimes the start point moves slightly. I try my best to keep on top of this. Okay, then I'm gonna open up these ones as well. These two don't really sound that interesting to me. Unexplored world. Do you think you can distinguish countries just by landscape, poles, trees, people, plates, vegetation, infrastructure, language, houses? Then look no more. Test your knowledge of the unexplored world. Here you'll find 95 countries that are not in GeoGuessr, but have some coverage. Only countries, so no, okay, already. I can tell that this will be too difficult. A skewed world. This map is designed to be played using the no moving, panning, or zooming game mode. A skewed world features 30,440 locations, randomly picked by AI, with the camera positioning offset by a preset angle to face away from roads. This does not guarantee hidden meta or clues, but will provide a very different challenge nonetheless. Trackers included. Credit to Slash Peak for the locations. What's this one? This is fastest growing cities in every U.S. state. This one's considered easy. So which do you think I should do? This one is moderate. This one is moderate. And this one is easy. Then there's only 50 options because we're in each state. Although I guess that would have to. Let's see. I'm gonna do GeoDetective. And it said that this is for non-moving games. Whereas this one is no moving, panning, or zooming. So I assume that means that I can pan and zoom on this game mode, which is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to play the GeoDetective map. I will pan, I will zoom, but I will not move. Let's play. Zoom, but I cannot move. Okay. Already failed, but I'm literally not clicking that. It's like doing that itself. I don't know why that's happening. I'm not clicking anything. I'm literally not clicking anything. I'm just gonna click up here. Says Rejeka Koper Zrakna Luka Centaur Center, I'm assuming. And there's some really like beautiful ornamental building here. This kind of looks like the Greek Colosseum, but I feel like this isn't Greek. I think the language looks different there. Also, I think that I've never been to Greece. I don't really know what kind of climate they have, but this looks odd. It's like a teddy bear. Certainly not the actual Carolina. I don't know, is this Greece? I don't really know. This language here, for some reason, this made me think of, like, the Czech Republic, or perhaps Ukraine. This looks more like I forget what it's called when it's those Eastern Russian type languages, but I thought Greece, the language looked different, but seeing this building, the only thing I can think of is the Colosseum, although from what photos I have seen of the Colosseum, I think that it is surrounded by a much different looking environment. But although I have my doubts, and I'm fairly certain that this is not Athens, and that is not the Colosseum, because, well, for the many reasons that I've stated, I can't think of what else it could be. I don't know what else it could be. I mean, yeah, this is definitely not it, though, because... we're down here at the water, and that's not gonna... I have no idea. This is really tricky. Rovinj Lim Fjord. Fjord. Are we potentially in Iceland or another Scandinavian country, maybe Sweden or Finland or Denmark or Norway? I don't think this is Norway. That's an American or an English, at least, stop sign. Rijeka, though. Rijeka, that kind of sounds like Reykjavik. Although, obviously, it's not Reykjavik, but I'm not sure. And then there's this. I'm not sure where this could be. Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Finland. What else is Estonia, Latvia? I don't know anything about these countries in here. I originally thought maybe it would be here, Czechia, but there's no water like that there. I don't know. I think I'm gonna go Iceland. I really don't know, so I'm just gonna pick something like this, but I'm sure it's quite wrong. Yes, I was very, very wrong. The incorrect location was Croatia. Okay, it was in Croatia. In Amphitheater Upuli, Roman Amphitheater and Underground Museum. Oh, parking Carolina. Okay, there's that Carolina that we saw before. And okay. I mean, yeah, realistically, I never would have known. nothing would have ever brought me to Croatia, even if I was able to move. 551 points. Your guess was 3,077 kilometers from the correct location. Next round. So this is not an English speaking country, I don't believe. Yeah, these people. Okay, palm tree. Surveillance camera there. There's a sign up here. But I can't tell what language is on that sign. They have a Hyundai. There's a giant Red Bull can right there. That's interesting, actually. Could this be maybe the Red Bull headquarters? And isn't Red Bull out of Austria, correct? Salzburg, right? Isn't that where Red Bull is out of? Is Salzburg? Am I mistaken? I might be mistaken, but I thought that Red Bull was out of Austria, right? Management. Okay, well that actually is in English. So that's interesting. Maybe we aren't in Austria. But this does say Ippler. And Ippler, I feel like, isn't, unless that's like a brand or something I've never heard of. I don't know. I don't see any other signs out here. No, this is potentially the UK, maybe, but I don't believe so. I'm just going to go with Austria, and okay, again, I didn't click anything there, it just kind of went on its own. The Red Bull, I feel like this might be the Red Bull headquarters, based on the fact that there's a giant Red Bull can here. This is like a very fancy, wealthy looking building. I feel like Red Bull might be out of Salzburg, just because, well, I don't know why I think that. I don't know why I believe that, but for some reason I believe that Red Bull is out of Salzburg, Austria. Although, the biggest city in Austria is Vienna. So wouldn't it make sense if they were there instead, but there's just something in the back of my head that tells me Salzburg. I'm not sure if exactly where in Salzburg, but I'm just gonna click there and click guess. Wow, I was actually really, really far away on that one. We were in Colombia, in the city of Bogota. Down here on right here. So what was that building with the giant Red Bull can? That would be, I'm not sure, I don't see any people value. Yeah, I'm not sure what that was all about then, but I only got 6 points. My guess was 9,406 kilometers in the correct location, so that was quite a bad round. Okay. Now, okay, College Road. that's where my mind is immediately taking me. Yeah, I think this is Florida because look at these boats here. We're on the US 1 in College Road. Something. says border kangaroo makes me think that this is Australia, but then I remember that Australia doesn't have any borders, because I assume that you do not have to cross actual borders to go between the different... Wow, I didn't realize just how vast and empty Australia is. You have Perth all the way over here, then Adelaide, Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane, like all these are here, but then Perth is by itself all the way over there, and there's really nothing up north. Like, can you even drive from Perth to Adelaide or Melbourne or whatever? Like, is that doable, or is that basically... Well, looks like you can. Obviously, there's a freeway that goes through, but I wonder how long that takes. Let's see. Let's go. Perth to Melbourne road trip. Yeah, let's see. No. How long does it take to drive from Melbourne to Perth? It takes well over 48 hours to get from Perth to Melbourne. The shortest driving time between Perth and Melbourne is approximately 3,000 kilometers long. Allow 7 to 14 days to get to Melbourne from Perth, depending on the route you decide to take. Why is that? Why is that going to take 7 to 14 days if it's only a 48-hour drive? That's interesting. But anyway, back to where we are. Border kangaroo. That says something. Harbor Links Golf. I don't know. I feel like this might be the U.S.-Mexico border, but we just had something in the United States, so I'm kind of, like, loath to go for that. But at the same time, like, I don't know where else this could be, because... something at Duna. Let's see if we come in through here. I just want to see if there's any, like, cities near the border that say at Duna or something. Something E-D-U-N-A. No, not really. Not really, but this is, what is this? This is... Harbor something, Harbor Links Golf Resort. So, harbor makes me think it's gonna be on the water, right? So, is it like something up in here? Costa Hermosa, Playas de Tijuana, Nectar Coffee, I don't know. Looking for, like, a golf course on a harbor near the border. So maybe it's over here down this side in Reynosa. Wow, this is actually a really complicated section of border right here. Look at this. Man, I don't know. Jardine, Guadalupe. This might not even be on the U.S.-Mexico border, to be fair, but, I don't know, I'm just gonna drop something, like, right there. I'm gonna guess that, but that's probably wrong. Oh my god, it was Australia. I made a joke about the border kangaroo, but it was actually Australia. Why are there border crossings in the same country? Is there something going on with, hold on, Australia border crossing? What the heck? Whoa, what the heck? I didn't realize that there was, why does Australia have internal borders? its own country. What are the borders of Australia? This is so weird. I don't understand. Is it just here? Western Australia border. The land border of the state of Western Australia bisects mainland Australia nominally along the 129th meridian east longitude. The border divides Western Australia from the Northern Territory and South Australia. In some places, for various reasons, the Western Australia town closest to the border is Kununurra, which is about 25 kilometers west of the border with the Northern Territories. Okay, but why do they exist? I don't get it. Like, they're telling me they exist. I understand that it exists, but I don't understand why it exists, because it's the same country. Right? Yes, Southern Australia, Western Australia border. Do you have to have a passport to travel within the same country? That's absolute madness. That's not normal, is it? I've never heard of that in any other country. Whatever, we got 0 points. We're playing the next round. My mind is genuinely blown right now. You learn something new every day. I'm gonna be reading about this legitimately as soon as I get done here. I'm gonna be reading about this. This is okay. Washington. Learner and Rowe. Attorney. Injury attorneys. 603-977-1900. Okay, we're in the United States. It looks like we are in a southern area. This could be Southern California. This could be Nevada. This could be Arizona. This has some faraway skyscrapers out there. That kinda makes me think of the Las Vegas Strip. But I've driven all over Nevada, and this might be in Phoenix. Because this kind of reminds me of the street signs, the way that they look in Phoenix, or at least in Tempe. They're this design, this big square. Okay. And that's, yeah, like a 602 area code. I don't know. That does nothing for me. Okay, to see if there's any like bumper stickers or anything. Right now I'm leaning Phoenix because I go to Phoenix like once a year, and that really looks like a Phoenix street sign. But I don't know. It's either Phoenix or Vegas. And I'm leaning Phoenix because Vegas does not have monorails like this. This is Phoenix. This has to be Phoenix. I don't know where in Phoenix, so I'm just gonna click Phoenix. But yeah, there we go. Conducted 10 expeditions. Cool. Okay. I got 4,986 points. Your guess is 3.8 kilometers from the correct location. So I just dropped it randomly and it ended up in this neighborhood, but this was actually on right here, Ballet. Where exactly is this? This is, okay, yeah, because the last time I stayed in Phoenix, I stayed like, where's downtown, where is, okay, Where's Tempe? Hold on, I want to find the exact hotel I stayed at. Where is the university? Arizona State University, okay. Because I walked to the ASU campus because I was actually thinking of transferring to ASU. Okay, here's University Drive. Yep, I stayed on University Drive at the original. There's the original chop shop. Okay, there's the pizza joint. University Drive. I stayed. Where was it? I'm going to find this hotel if it's the last thing I do. It's Fifth University. Apache. It was on University. I know that for a fact. Okay. Rallies. 3-minute car wash. Great room escape. Axe throwing. Taco Bell. Circle K. Solaris. I'm not. Oh man, I don't know if I'm gonna find it. I don't know if I'm gonna find it now. That sucks. But I can tell you this. Where's the campus? Down here. Where is that? I had this really good sandwich here. I wish I could find it here because I want to. If you guys are ever in Tempe, this sandwich place here was really good. It was called Sub and Something or Something and Sub. I don't know why I'm not finding it. That's really, really weird. Because yeah, Arizona State University campus is right here. And then the... Okay, yeah, there's the Whataburger. Unless... I don't know. I know it's a pretty big campus, but surely it's... not that big to where I'm missing it. Wow. Now I feel like I've let you guys down twice. Wait. This is where the Sun Devil Stadium's at. Hold on. That's not the part of the campus I was at. Because I wasn't ever near the stadium, I don't think. Was I? I could have sworn I wasn't. Okay, there's the Raising Cane's. Man, Iron Gloves Boxing Gym. Okay, I walked to that Iron Gloves Boxing Gym because I wanted to check out their prices because, like I was saying, I was considering transferring to ASU from my current school. Okay, this is rural. Yeah, this is... Man, I don't know. This is weird. Weird. Like, I was here. I've walked all over this area, but for some reason, I'm, like, having a hard time getting my bearings. Anyway... sorry for that big detour. I did really bad this game. I thought Australia was Mexico. I thought Iceland was Croatia. I thought Mexico was Australia. I did it backwards again. I thought Australia was Mexico. I thought Croatia was Iceland. I thought Austria was Colombia. That's the biggest mess up. I got the Arizona one correct, and I got the Florida one basically correct. So, the two in the United States, I did good, but the guys so much for watching. Please leave a thumbs up if you liked the video and subscribe to this channel for more content.